And it was, the question was, I found your school online and I want to know, are you more of a competition gym or a teaching gym? And I'd never had that question before, and I had to even say, like, in reply, that I don't know quite what a teaching gym would be, but I try to answer those questions as best as possible. And I said, my school, I've always dubbed it as mixed martial arts for fitness and self-defense, meaning it is for sport and street, meaning health, fitness, game, but also that it should translate into personal protection. And that meaning, the techniques that I'll show, and even in tonight's grappling class, I'll commonly show a technique and then just say, okay, now if you're gonna do this to actually protect yourself, this might not be the exact choice you wanna make. You might wanna modify it, you might wanna change it, or discard it altogether, because when it's in the street, I might not wanna do a double leg takedown on the concrete and tie up with one person when he has accomplices and they might have knives in their pockets. So it really makes no sense. And it's commonly said, the way that you train is the way that you're gonna fight under pressure. So if I tie up with somebody and I love the jiu-jitsu move of doing a flying triangle on a person and landing on my back and submitting the person and looking glamorous and glorious and it being a good cage fight maneuver that gets applause, it's gonna get my ass kicked in the street and probably gonna do more damage to me, and it's not the optimal situation. But, if Randy were here, I'd let him speak for himself. I also told this, answered this person and said, you know, we have had, Randy's somebody that had a cage fight at casino, I'm not even sure which one, and won his fight, and I take no credit for that, it's him, but I would hope that it's because he learned lessons and drills that helped him achieve a win. So I would hope every gym that somebody goes to is a learning experience. I don't know what it would be like to just be complete competition. And also, I'll refer people. I say, go check out this school. I know of this one. There's stuff on my resource page. I say, I know that there's this one place that's kind of solely driven on competition. But here, I like to balance it out. And then we have people that I've had students that have done submission tournaments and been very successful at them. But for the majority, like those people that cross-train with us or even train for competition, we're month to month, so, you know, particular people you can note, you know, we see them strong, training hard, and then we don't see them for a while. And then they come back and they'll train for a competition. So those people, great to have them, but longevity, it's usually the people that are training for health purposes or just that they like playing the game of jiu-jitsu, but they're not doing it to win over a crowd or anything. You can fight as hard as you want with one another and still have competition. I thought that was kind of cool. And also, like, sometimes I'm not as crazy about the local MMA circuit. I don't completely support it fully. If certain things changed about it, or if, like, any, I've even mentioned on my website, if, like, a band of instructors wanted to get together and we would contribute funds and make it a public event that was free, I think it would be really fascinating and great and attract different people and educate different people, and it wouldn't be like the moneymaker, and I wouldn't charge people to compete, and we would pay for it all, and I would completely fund my share of that. But I put that on my website like a year or two ago, and I've never had anybody take me up on it. And so it's usually people want sponsors and people want to be able to turn a profit on it, and that's cool, but it attracts a different vibe.